Didn't want anybody to touch it, she just said. Oh, well, I don't.
Come along, they had a tree next to
that's a great picture, grandma's back.
Big wind come along, lifted the house up off the foundation, dropped the house back down, knocked the tree over there. Everybody was hysterical. Ever since then, she's been scared of storms, because everybody got upset about it. Yeah.
They had one company there at home. And this old woman lived in this old, the house was built, the school was over there. But it was one room house, she don't have, she used to have.
Sing a pretty song.
And she was in there, listened to her radio. Rocket. And this tornado come through. Went to that cabin up, and they never found it. And didn't miss a hair on her head, she stayed right there in that rocket.
You just looked it right up off her?
Yeah, right up off her. This is,
Not a relative.
Oh, no, that's.
It's not very stable.
Friend of my uncle's lived out in the country.
What a story.
What the heck was her name? Oh, she's an old woman. And then it lifted my dad's cow up, my uncle's cow, milk cow, and set her up in front of a tree. Didn't hurt her, just set her up on top of the tree. And he had to build a platform up there to her to get her out of there.
Where's his ball out?
Where's his?
Pepper.
Well, I tell you what,
strange things.
I think she had lodged up there, her stomach, in the crotch of the tree here, so her feet couldn't touch nothing, so she couldn't kick herself out of there.
Where's his?
But what he did, he built it. He built a ramp, a wooden ramp up for a tour.
That's salt time.
Yeah.
Try not to bump her on the table.
Yeah, ashtray, huh?
I think it might been better just to
Secret.
You know how, you get a lot of tornadoes, and it picks up all the little varmints, or squirrels, and fish out of the lake, frogs and stuff, drops them down a mile, 2 miles. That does it out on the ocean if you get into a, one of those water spouts. Yeah, I've been fishing around them suckers, and you can see them out there, And next thing you know, clouds coming over there, and all of a sudden, all the damn bait fish is flying all over you, dropping down there. Of course, it's not hard to suck a little bait fish.
Like sardines?
Yeah.
What are you doing? Don't put the pepper in the salt.
Get down.
Yeah, I've seen it. These water spouts doing that. You know, out there in Arizona, they get those dust bunnies.
Yeah.
They really whip that dust up.
And
you wonder, what's causing it? Because where you are, there ain't no wind.
No, no wind at all. None at all.
All the wind will be right there in that little dust bin. Finally, it'll play out. Go out across the desert here and cross the highway.
You get some of those southern states like Oklahoma, Texas, New Mexico, and places like that. You get a lot of strangers coming into that state. And they get down to those arroyos. And the son of a bitches are camping in an arroyo.
Yeah, I know.
And man, you don't even have to know it, but 5 or 6 miles up or down or whatever, they can have a hell of a storm come through. And you don't even know the storm has come through to up there.
20 foot of wall of water.
And boy, a wall of water be coming down there. Man.
And you know, at home, I've been out, frog gigging and stuff like that at nighttime, and go up through a roar like that and come across this camp up there, people camping. And around the camp, and I'll come out and tell them, hey, you're in a bad place. What do you mean bad fishing? I said, well, you see that big bank there? Them banks maybe 15 foot tall, both sides of them. I said, you get a flood upstream. I said, the water's going to be at the top of that.
They think you...
They think I'm just bullshit. And I tell them, hey, I'm telling them the truth. I warned them. I said, there if you want to. But I said, you couldn't pay me to camp here. I said, there's too many high places I can camp on.
That's the damnedest thing.
And every time, guess where they be from? California. Every goddamn time. Yeah. I'm California.
Them people in a different world, I tell you. They are all in a different world.
They're living out there in California, and they know they got their earthquakes and all that good stuff out there, and they know it happens. But they won't believe you. No way.
I remember I took a bunch of Weevilos out, about 14 of them, with about 6 Boy Scouts on a weekend campout. And it rained that night after we got our tent set up.
Somebody turned it on.
Man, it was a mess. I mean,
keep it on.
Pulled us on up to higher ground, got in a pavilion, and next day we went back up to camp all square away. But after we were off, that's it. Put your hand over that. Got everybody dried out. Got all through the camp. I had a pretty good weekend. I had 5 people get injured on the camp out.
Oh, Daniel.
You know who they were?
Daniel.
5.
We found him. Where'd you get him?
Of the 6 Boy Scouts.
Matt got it.
One got burned on his hand. One ran through the camp and hit a damn lantern and knocked his ass silly. He was out like that. But they all know you're not supposed to run in camp. I mean, you know, that's like, you know, Boy Scout 101, man. Another one. I don't like axes. Never did like them. Wasn't allowed to carry axes after that. Missed the thing, went alongside his foot. 7 stitches went right down to the bone. I run him to the hospital. That's another Boy Scout. And that kid was over 16 years of age. He had better sense than that. He knew all about that shit. He was freaking den chief. Then I had another kid got burned on a cook stove. I mean, you know, little, and another kid cut his hand with a knife. 5 out of 6, I was so pissed off at him. I chewed their asses up and down. I'm worried about the little guys, see, not like him.
Yeah.
And the damn scouts are dropping left and right. But we got through everything all right. So the next meeting I had with the kids, you know.
But his friend Lydia came.
These are the older Cub Scouts. These are the Weebelos. You know. When I asked them, I said, well, we went boating, we went swimming, we went hiking, we went fishing. We had archery, wasn't rifle shooting, but we had BB rifles, target practice. Oh, hell, I can't remember what. I treat them just like Boy Scouts, you know. Got them all through there. And I figured, well, you know, let me check with this thing, see what the hell's going on. So I get them all together and said, all right, I want to find out what we did. What was it that you liked most about this camp out? God damn, every one of those kids in unison like they were getting rained out of her tents at their first night, getting washed out. They thought that was the greatest damn thing. And I thought, that's not nothing. Well, wait, let me get that. To an adult, that was a catastrophe. But I could see maybe to a kid, that was something to brag about.
Yeah.
They liked everything else, but the one thing that they remembered was getting washed out and how upset I was with myself. But it wound up all right, except for that one kid that... And the other thing was, this kid's parents was Seventh-day Adventists. That was great.
I had there in Norfolk, or in Virginia Beach, I was district commissioner. And I had a troop, they had planned a survival week, whole week, in the Desert Swamp.
What is that comedian we watch all the time?
Well, their scoutmaster come down with Pennsylvania.
Mark Russell.
So, they were disappointed when they get to go. So I said, what the hell, I'll take it. So we went. And I was used to Desert Swamp because I coon hunted down there all the time. And went down there. Only thing we took, no food. We took flint and steel. No matches.
No. Yeah.
And we went down there and I had 21 of them. And one of our parents was saying,
I wonder if that's your real hair color. If I peroxide my hair, it would come out that color.
I don't think it's natural.
Besides Robin Rollins, the tension must be
beat Matt Gregory Peck and the Bible for a spoken word Grammy and launched his own publishing and record companies. You know the phrase 24 and 7? Meet Mr. 25 and 8. When Henry Rollins began his explosive stint with Black Flag,
You don't understand. These are modern times.
Well, I never did a scream and yell on Elvis or Frank Sinatra. I always thought they were stupid.
They swoon.
Yeah, I just used to think they're about the dumbest people I've ever seen. So I would never been allowed to express that kind of emotion. It's improper, and it is. To me, it is improper. It'll teach you to give away to things that aren't.
Yeah, I was raised kind of
same way. Oh yeah.
I admire people who can.
I've had girls come into my scouting and be standing there. They just be standing. And I said, "What's wrong, honey? What's wrong?" I have to shake them and say, "What the hell is wrong?" Bug. Shoot.
Bug.
I bugged them. I told them.
Step on it.
Shut up. Stupid. What are you going to do when you have a child? You're going to stand there? Well, stop and think a minute.
Probably.
You used to take them out and I wouldn't allow them to yell and scream over snakes. Every one of my girls eventually got to pick up a snake, and that would, of course, be a banana or something like that. And I told them, I says, when you are grown and you look out the door and gulp because your child is standing next to a snake, and it may be a rattler, you have got to be calm. You have to. I said, this is it. You're through being and one of the other leaders, wonderful person, absolutely went hysterical when she saw a snake. She said, of no use whatsoever if any of her girls got a snake.
Well, you watch this 911 program every now and then, and these people call 911 and they're so hysterical, you can't get any information out of them.
I would be 911 hysterical if my kid was in the swimming pool. If my child fell out of a window high up, I'd be hysterical.
Yeah, I would be too.
I probably would jump out the window after him.
But I think you've managed to control yourself enough that you...
I think the maddest I ever got was I was in my kitchen doing my laundry there in Norfolk, Virginia. And this hysterical broad came right in and said, "Oh, he's been hit! She's been hit! She's been hit! She's been hit! She's been hit! Nice to meet you! Oh!" And I went outside.
Grandma.
And there was kid screaming bloody murder, not a drop of blood anywhere. And I looked at the kid, and I looked at the lady, and he said, she ran into me. Everybody else jumping up and down and yelling. Shall we call an ambulance? And I'm looking at her. And so I took her and her mother, the child and the mother, to the doctor. I think it was a doctor that went right down to her. And I walked in, and they says, "What's the matter?" Kid screaming bloody murder, mother. I said, "I think you better take care of the mother first, because I'll tell you the truth, well, I think she's worse off than I know the kid's all right." And I told her, I said, "You're a damn fool. I have no use for you whatsoever."
Yeah, the kid has to depend on you for...
Well, the kid got hysterical, which could, to me, cause more damage. Getting it to run or do something really idiotic.
I think we're on
camera. Tell me, there is a time when all this stupidness ends. Kathy's at the age when all that stupidness ends.
I'm not the answer, what?
When stupid things act, if you see a snake, you don't scream and yell.
That's right.
That's right. Good for you.
Heard of snakes, yeah.
I used to disappoint my boys on my bus. I used to disappoint my soul, you know, they'd get a snake and put it in a sack and get on the bus and then sit down there. It was real quiet, you knew something.
Yeah.
And they say, "Bus driver, how do you like this?" And I said, "That's nice." I said, "That's pretty good size, though, right?"
Yeah, can you read that?
"Be sure to show it to your science teacher." Oh, they were just...
Well, now.
You just see him die. John Ray stood in the door there in Memphis. And he had his hand up. John was 6 foot here. Here he goes. "Hey, mother, how you like this cottonmouth I killed?" And I looked at it, and the tail was wiggling.
Yeah.
I said, "Well, John, I think it would be nice if you really did kill it."
"That one here, too." Right?
And his eyes got bad. I said, "His tail's big. Oh, my God. Oh, my God." And there he had a live cottonmouth on his head. That's how big that thing was. I don't know whether he thought the tail would come up and wrap around and choke him the other way. He thought, "Well, I'm seeing this snake." And chucked me out the door. I wasn't about to follow because I wasn't going to help her kill that snake.
He lost my hand.
His daddy had lived through two bites. Why wouldn't he?
Jesse, take her to wash her hands and get her shorts back on.
We used to, of course, mother had a garden and everything was all that was working.
Oh, poor Kathy, I don't know where pants are.
Things like that. And there was always chicken snacks around, what you call black racers.
Black racers, yeah.
And mom would be out in the garden and you could say, no, there was a cartoon one time, this old woman would be always like a snake. Mom would be out there and she'd chase the snake, you know. Yelling, "It's a snake, it's a snake."
She had a reason to kill a snake. It was eat the eggs and things like that.
Yeah. It was scary. It hurts! Instead of taking hard to chase it.
I never killed a snake. Well, when we were out there camping one time in the Virginia hills, this lady came up. I despised this woman anyway. She's the dumbest leader I ever saw. And a bunch of the girls came over and they said, "We're going for a hike." What's the matter with that?
Try that again.
I said, "I don't think I would go out. I'm not going to have cotton mouths all right." In the daytime, he should have said that. "Well, now I don't think I'm wrong. He might actually step on one and he would probably take injections to
it."
And he says, "Oh, we'll watch out. We have flashlights." I said, "You're a jackass." took very long to go much on the back there. She says,
no,
you got hold of the wrong one.
Oh, what's in there?
You're not slick.
He's in a daze.
He deserves it.
Oh, sorry.
He always deserves it.
We go bye bye.
We go bye bye.
Yeah, we go bye bye.
No, we're not. We are bye bye. Grandma's house.
Here, give me some more.
Give it to Chris, please.
I don't know what kind of noise.
I know they've been running out. They got me going out their head. Yes.
Kathy, get her some more milk. Get her milk. Get her milk, Kathy.
That may bother your mind how we used to have to
pick it
without
making
any noise.
Yeah.
It was embarrassing when you made noise.
Oh, yeah.